Hello there, good morning. This is Sophie from One Marine. We're going to show you something a little bit different today. This is the Silvistris 23 Sports Cabriolet, and the owner, Mr. Simon Hartnell, is going to actually give you a full walk around of the vessel on her trailer. This is one of our most unique listings. We think she's absolutely stunning, and we'd like to see what you think too. Handing over now.
Good morning, this is Simon Hartnell. I'm just going to walk you through the Silvestris. So here she is, and then I'll zoom into various bits in a minute. So starting at the bow, she sits on an SBS trailer that you've seen the invoice for. Came from SBS in the UK, and there is the plate that tells you all about the trailer. But obviously you've got that on the invoice. So the trailer's 2 years old and was put together specifically for this boat. So the boat's in pretty good nick. She's not perfect, as I explained to you. There's the odd little dink and nick on her that has been here from prior to our ownership. But generally, she's in very good condition. She's got about 100 hours. There's that white board there is the number plate board, the light board that sits on the back of the trailer here. She's got twin props, and that is the registration number that obviously ties in with the paperwork. So she's currently got sea anodes on her, saltwater anodes on her, but obviously those could be changed if she was to be used in freshwater. Twin axle trailer, and I was explaining to you on the phone that it's got a flushing point. You can see the red pipes down in here, and those red pipes are hose pipes that you can connect a hose connector onto it and flush the trailer when it's been in the water. So here are the hatches shut and the deck. There's the odd little bit of blistering of paint, as you can see here, but nothing major at all, and nothing that couldn't be sorted out. There's a little bit of blistering on that exhaust pipe too. So obviously these are the through deck exhausts that you know about. And then if we go on round the boat, you'll see here it's all pretty together, and there are no scratches on this side, barring that tiny little mark. And you can see that with the sunlight, there's a tiny little mark there. I'll now do another video of the hatches and the deck. Peter, now we have a walking tour of the top of the boat. So on the bow we have two locks that bring the bonnet up, and as you'll appreciate, in here we have a great bit of storage. There you can see the tubular space frame, spare fuel just in case, and then in here we have an anchor locker, which has our anchor protected by some fenders. On the bow and all around the boat you have pop-up cleats. And just showing you, there's the odd little mark on the paintwork, but nothing that a little bit of work wouldn't sort out. Fuel fillers on either side. And there is the categorization. So in second. So, fuel fillers from the deck, windscreen wipers, the other fuel filler, and the navigation lights. So the windscreen is strong enough for you to hold on to and to walk around. And then we come to the cockpit. So, in here, we have leather seats which are in really good condition. Really good condition, no marks at all. We have the, over here, we have the ignition and the kill cord. The two buttons on there, up and down, are the trim for the engine. The steering wheel, the throttle, all of the gauges and buttons that control. Here we have a glove box that is quite difficult to access, but that's what it is. Nets on the side. Down here we have a stereo controller and a fridge. And then under here we have the control panel for the bilge pumps and the fire suppression system and the speakers for the stereo. That little vent in the bottom corner there is for the heating system, which will blow warm air from the engine bay over you whilst you're going along. So then we come to the back seats, where again there's good grab rails on either side, leather's in great condition, a few little marks on the side of the paint, but again nothing that couldn't be sorted. And she is a 4.5 seater. So there's a little jump seat in the middle. She's licensed for 5, and there's the jump seat in the middle. And then finally, I will turn around and show you the engine bay. I mentioned to you that the rear light does not work, the rear navigation light, and that is there. Two catches for the boot, or the engine locker, which comes up on a hydraulic ram, as you can see. And then given that the boat is 13 years old, the engine is in very good condition. Only about 100 hours. And recently serviced. She has battery isolators on either side. One that does the engine and one that does the main electrics for the boat. And then finally, as you know, there are the exhausts up on the top here that obviously when you push the button on the dashboard allow you to channel the noise particularly, and the exhausts out through the deck that makes her sound fantastic. A few scratches on the top of the deck here in the white, but nothing of any major significance. Okay, so here is a video of the engine starting and then running. Now of the valves opening on deck.
Thanks, Simon, for that thorough walk around. We think she's absolutely gorgeous. She's certainly a head turner on the water, and she's not for the shy at heart, because people just can't help but look. If you think she might be the one for you, please give us a call at One Marine. Speak to Sophie and we'll try and match it up. Thanks very much. Bye for now.